Here you go, Sons. Wake us up a bit, eh?
Hopefully.
Yes, love. What can I do you for?
I've just been raped. By my husband.
Okay, Kathy, thanks. Right, it's Maggie Fisher, isn't it? I'm WPC Narika Datta. Narika. My partner, WPC Michelle Hughes, will be here shortly. So will the DI. That's Detective Inspector Burnside. He'll be running the investigation. But Michelle and I will be the people looking after you. Right, before we go any further, could you tell me briefly what happened earlier this morning? It was this morning.
6:17. I saw the clock.
And it was your husband, you say?
Mark Fisher.
So, was this at home, in your flat?
House. In the bedroom.
And what happened? Briefly.
He wouldn't accept that when I said no, I meant no.
Michelle, what's the story?
I've only just got here, sir, sorry. Looks like Narika's still getting the details.
Husband, isn't it?
According to Reg.
I've been waiting for one of these to turn up. Right, let us know as soon as you got something. That is, if there's anything to get.
We split up, you see, about 4 months ago. Last night we had a meal at a restaurant, the Palermo in Duke Street. I thought we were going to discuss, you know, selling the house and everything. But Mark...
It's okay, take your time.
Mark thought we were going to talk about getting back together, apparently. Anyway, he had too much to drink and couldn't drive, so I said he could stay at the house, on the sofa bed. Which he did. Till I woke up at 6:17 with him climbing all over me. I told him to get off. He wouldn't. He just kept saying I was his wife and he loved me. When I said I'd scream, he grabbed me here and said I'd better not. Then he raped me.
He forced you to have intercourse without your consent.
That's what rape means, doesn't it? Sorry.
It's okay. Then what happened?
Then he got dressed and went off to work.
And what did you do?
Got dressed, got a cab, came here.
Were you wearing anything in bed? Did you take a bath before you left?
No.
Or eat anything?
Full English breakfast.
Morning.
Well, where's the fire then? I thought we got a rape on.
We have. Maybe.
Husband and wife.
Oh, I see ya. Narika's gonna tell us about it when she gets here. Oh.
Right, sir. Husband's name is Mark Fisher. She says he raped her this morning, then went off to work.
Sounds like some of the blokes I know. Well, face it, it's going to come down to arguing the toss about consent, isn't it?
Where is she now?
Narika's taking her to the rape suite.
And is this where the husband works? GR Financial Services?
In Holborn, yeah.
So what is he? Insurance salesman? Well, let's hope he's fully comprehensive, then.
Thank you. So, how can I help you?
I'm Detective Constable Lyons, Son Hill. This is DC Carver.
Oh, well... You wouldn't be our first police clients. Got a superintendent, in fact.
We're actually investigating a serious allegation made by your wife, Mr. Fisher. Rape.
Maggie's been raped?
Yes. She says by you. I thought you might like to come to the station with us. Just to give us your side of the story.
There's a small bruise here. Hurt?
Not really.
Any idea how you got it?
No.
Show me how he gripped you.
Why would she say I raped her? I mean, okay, we're going through a bad patch right now, but that doesn't mean we can't sleep together, does it?
Let's get to the station, Mr. Fisher. We can sort it all out down there.
I mean, she's still my wife, right?
Hello, sir. We're upstairs. Sofa bed's in there. Still out. Used to her clearing up, I suppose.
Any sign of a fight or a struggle?
Bed was in a mess, but nothing extraordinary.
Blood?
No, sorry, sir. What do you reckon?
Oh, well, there's definitely been intercourse recently. And there is some light bruising on her jaw, consistent with it having been gripped tightly. Nothing dramatic, though. For the rest, you'll have to wait for the report.
Right. She's still in the shower.
20 minutes.
Do you think we should check her?
Give her a little longer. Still a long way off the record.
You got the husband?
Yeah, he's downstairs waiting for a solicitor.
Oh, he's like that, is he?
Well, he doesn't deny sleeping with her. He just says she was a willing partner, that's all.
Like I said, it's all going to come down to consent.
Thank you, Perry Mason.
No, sir. Right, bye. I brought the husband in. How do you feel?
Like I've been sandblasted.
You look great. We have to get back to Sunhill, I'm afraid.
I was just getting settled in.
Sorry, this place is in demand. When you've had a chance to rest for a bit, we'll take you home or wherever. We'll take a proper statement from you later when you feel up to it.
I've already given you a statement, haven't I?
Not really. That was just a few facts to set the wheels in motion.
You mean I've got to go through it all, again, in more detail?
I'm afraid so, yeah.
You know, I'm not so sure about all this.
What do you mean?
Well, if you look at it logically, what he did wasn't anything I didn't let him do hundreds of times when we were together.
Force you to have sex with him against your will?
Persuade me, yes.
Threaten you with violence? Hurt you?
No. The thing is, this morning when I came in, I was incensed, you know. I mean, how dare he? Now I just don't know whether it's worth it, that's all.
Well, Maggie, you're the only person who can decide that. I mean, if you want to go on with this, we'll be right behind you, but you must want to. I mean, we can't pretend it's going to be easy in court. If it ever comes to court, you'll have to...
What do you mean, if? If it comes to court?
Well, so far, there's not a lot of evidence. It's only your word against his.
You've spoken to him?
One of our colleagues has.
And?
Well, I don't suppose it'll come as any surprise that he's saying you're a willing partner.
The little creep. All right, then. I'm all yours.
Jim, you busy? Good. I want you to go down to the Palermo restaurant. Talk to Manuel or Miguel, whoever it is, runs the place. See if you can find any evidence to give this rape allegation some legs. Otherwise, Mr. and Mrs. Fisher are going to be sorting this one out themselves.
Right, Gov.
Narika.
We're back in the DVU, sir. Maggie Fisher wants to make a statement now.
She up to it?
Seems to be, yeah.
Right. Well, we better go and see what Abby's got to say. Come on, Tosh.
Go. Sir? Well, wouldn't it be better to wait till we got everything from Maggie? Give you more to go on.
And how long's that going to take? I mean, Fisher's downstairs now with his brief. They're up to trot.
Yeah, but wouldn't it be better if you had the full story, sir?
She was asleep. He came into the room. She said no. He said yes. He had his wicked way. That is the story. Her story.
I think we should at least hear what he's got to say, don't you?
I mean, for all we know, they might have spent a night of passion together. And she's got the hump because he forgot to kiss her goodbye.
I hardly think so.
Don't you believe it. Number of false alarms we get. Look, we know where he lives, right? So he can't go anywhere. So if Maggie does come up with something to nail him, which I doubt, we can always bring him back in again.
Sir.
It's So, Mr. Fisher, I'm Detective Inspector Burnside. I'm sorry about all this inconvenience, but a very serious allegation has been made against you. And obviously, we have to investigate it. You understand?
Yes, of course.
You also understand that you're not under arrest. You're free to leave at any time. You also don't have to say anything unless you wish to do so. But what you do say may be given in evidence.
Well, my client is keen to cooperate fully with your inquiries, Inspector.
Well, glad to hear it, Mr. Atkin.
Well, you're aware, I trust, that Mr. and Mrs. Fisher are separated and currently in dispute over the terms of the divorce.
So?
Well, obviously, if Mr. Fisher were in prison for rape, he'd be at a severe disadvantage contesting any settlement.
Ah, right. Interview with Mark Fisher. Those present, Detective Inspector Burnside, Detective Constable Lines. Also present, Mr. Fisher's solicitor, Edward Atkin. 11:38. Right, Mr. Fisher, would you like to give us your version of what happened last night and this morning?
Well, my wife and I had dinner last night at an Italian restaurant, the Palermo.
Who invited who?
I can't really remember. It just came up in the conversation on the phone a few days ago. I think she suggested it so we could iron a few things out, and I thought she meant, you know, emotionally between us. And I thought, why not? Give it one last go, you know.
So you wanted to get back together again?
Quite honestly, before last night, I didn't know. I love her, but, you know.
So what happened?
We had a nice enough meal, civilized. She was very sweet, really, which surprised me. She can be very cutting. Anyway, by the time the bill arrived, I realized I'd drunk far too much to drive. We both had. So I said I'd get a cab home. She said that was silly, because I'd have to come all the way back here tomorrow, today, to pick the car up, and that I should doss down at the house.
She suggested that you come back?
Yes.
Go on.
Well, I did. We walked home, and she put me in the lounge on the sofa bed, and I went to sleep.
And?
Well, about 6 o'clock, I woke up, and I said to myself, this is silly, us like this, and I went upstairs.
Yeah?
I woke Maggie up, and I told her how I was feeling, that we shouldn't be apart.
And how did she react to that?
Well, she agreed.
That you should get into bed with her?
Yeah.
And then what?
My wife and I made love.
So you asked him back?
Yes. It was ridiculous him getting a cab. I never suggested he was coming back for anything except sleep, alone, downstairs.
Even so, cosy meal for two, invitation back to your place. Some people might say you were asking for trouble.
They can say what they like. I didn't ask him to rape me.
You're not living at home at the moment, then, Mr. Fisher?
With a friend in Fulham, left a couple of months ago.
Left or thrown out?
We agreed I should go, give us both some space.
So what was the trouble?
Difficult to say, really.
It's all right. I've been there. It's always something, though, isn't it? What was it, money?
Not really.
No, of course not. You both got good jobs, haven't you? Who, in fact, earns the most, you or your wife?
Is this relevant?
Well, I'm just trying to understand your relationship, Mr. Fisher. You see, you say that your wife agrees to you getting into bed and making love to her, and then she turns around and accuses you of rape because she thinks somehow that's going to get her a better divorce settlement.
I didn't say that. I don't know why she's doing this.
It's a possibility I've floated, Inspector. After all, it's not uncommon to try to blacken one's partner in divorce cases, is it?
Well, it's a bit strong, though, isn't it? I mean, she must be earning a few quid, working for a city accountant. And you sell insurance?
I work in financial services, yes.
Well, I was just wondering who earns more, just out of interest.
She does, now.
And do you think this had anything to do with your marriage splitting up?
No, and it wasn't why I raped her either. I mean, it doesn't mean I raped her either.
It's all right, Mr. Fisher. I know what you mean.
Right, Maggie, just a few points I want to clarify, if you can bear it. This bit where you say it never occurred to you that Mark might come into your room.
Yes.
Well, playing devil's advocate, I'd say that two people who were once close and have had quite an intense evening...
It wasn't intense.
Well, you said at one point he told you he still loved you.
Well, it wasn't intense for me. As far as I was concerned, we were discussing business.
Okay. But if a bloke I'd just split up from had told me he still loved me and he'd been drinking and I asked him back to spend the night in another room, okay, but still in the same house, well, it would have at least crossed my mind that he might try something on.
He didn't try something on. He raped me. Look, I know Mark. I've lived with him for 4 years. It never occurred to me he'd do anything like that. To tell you the truth, I didn't think he had it in him. Ironic, isn't it? That's why I married him. The sex, if I'm honest. His mother thought I was after him for his money. Her boy was going to be rich and successful, apparently. But really, it was just great in bed. Once. Can hardly remember it now. Besides, well, you're probably going to find out anyway now I've been opened to the world. There's somebody else. Has been for about a year. He was with me the night before Mark stayed.
So, if it wasn't the money or your wife's job, what was the problem?
I never said it wasn't her job. It was how much she earned that wasn't a problem. It was quite nice having so much coming in. Dinkies, you know. Dual income, no kids. Only she wanted to get on, climb the greasy pole, so she was around less and less. Always someone going under that she had to rush off to see in Dumfries or Wincanton or God knows where.
And you didn't like that?
You get married to be with someone.
So you drifted apart?
Suppose so.
Affairs?
Not me, no.
But her?
Dunno. You never know, do you?
But you suspected something?
Maybe.
So can I take it that your sexual relationship during this period was...
Oh, wonderful. Earth moved every night.
So before this morning, when was the last time you and your wife had sex together?
To be honest, I can't remember.
Because it was so long ago?
Because I can't remember.
So this morning, she suddenly has a complete change of heart.
Female prerogative, I thought, changing your mind.
And saying no, even to her husband.
She didn't say no.
You sure about that, Mr. Fisher?
Yes.
You sure you didn't misinterpret a no for a yes? Think she was playing hard to get?
No.
Maybe you decided to ignore it altogether, show her who was boss.
No.
Let me get this right, Mr. Fisher. You say that your wife went off you. Then all of a sudden, she changes her mind and lets you make love to her. Then immediately afterwards, she changes her mind back again, comes straight down here and reports you for raping her. Is that what you're saying?
All I know is she was fine when I left. Even took her a cup of tea, same as usual.
She didn't drink it.
Your wife has some marks on her jawline, Mr. Fisher. Bruises. Consistent with someone gripping her hard there. Do you know anything about that?
No.
She says you did it. While you forced her to have sex with you.
Well, I suppose she'd have to, wouldn't she? I mean, for all I know, she might have been with a different man every night for the past 4 months, mightn't she?
Do you think she has been? Ugh. Not knowing what your wife has been up to has been getting to you, hasn't it, Mr. Fisher?
I believe it, sir. So does Michelle.
What about this Fisher character?
Glib.
Sells insurance.
Well, that doesn't make him a rapist. Did he put his story to the wife?
Yeah, she agrees with it. Only, of course, she says she said no. He says she said yes.
And what about the restaurants?
Well, there's nothing there, sir. The manager reckons they had a quiet meal. They drank a couple of bottles of house white. He doesn't know who had how much, and they left about 11.
Well, it's your call, Frank. I've got no words of wisdom.
Well, I don't think we've got enough to charge. I mean, I'm going to shove it up to the can't prosecute service, but I can't see them being very impressed.
Great. I can't wait to tell Maggie.
For what it's worth, Narika, I think he probably did it. But I also reckon he doesn't think he's done anything wrong. I mean, the finger marks on the face might have swung it, but now there's a boyfriend in the frame.
Well, they can't use that against her in court.
Oh, come on.
Well, they're not meant to. But any defence brief worth his salt will try and bring it in.
Why don't we put an ad in the paper? If your husband rapes you, don't bother the Met, because there's nothing we can do.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, in this case, on this evidence, there isn't.
About time.
Yeah, I'm sorry to have kept you waiting. You'd be pleased to know, Mr. Fisher, that our inquiries are now complete.
Oh, good.
But we will be forwarding the papers to the CPS for their decision. My advice to you, in your own best interest, is to stay well away from Mrs. Fisher. We wouldn't want any more misunderstandings between you, would we?
Mr. Fisher and I have already discussed what he should and shouldn't do, Inspector.
Good. Right, you're free to go. Oh, Reg, do me a favour. Could you show these two gentlemen out, please?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Thanks for your cooperation, Mr. Fisher.
Would you like to come this way, gents?
Marital rape, Gov.
Alleged.
I'll blame the feminists myself. So they got going, it wasn't even a crime, was it?
You mean I've been through all that for nothing?
It's not for nothing, Maggie. We've done all we can. Now it's up to the CPS.
So, what's to stop him coming back and doing it again?
Well, he's been warned to stay right away from you. And there's no reason now for him to come over to this part of town, is there?
Who knows?
Cheer up, Frank. You did your best.
Yeah, except no one's happy.
Your friend's getting here at 3, yeah?
Yeah.
I'll wait with you till she comes.
Oh, it's not necessary, really.
Well, I don't think you should be alone.
Right. Thanks.
Hello.
What the hell are you doing here?
I live here.
Not anymore.
I've decided to move back.
You can't!
After taking legal advice.
How dare you? Get him out!
And who might you be?
WPC Data, Sunhill Police.
Oh, well, I don't think she can get me out, darling.
You said he's been warned to stay away.
He has.
But I wasn't charged with anything. I wasn't even arrested. So, according to my solicitor, there's absolutely no reason I can't come back here. To my own home. Is there, Constable? Oh, apparently, it's very important I should be living here right now, for the final settlement. Possession being 9/10 of the law and all that.
You bastard. You complete and utter bastard!
You don't do anything you might regret, do you?
Maggie, I think we should talk.
Is it true? You really can't get him out?
Well, in law, he hasn't actually done anything wrong.
He raped me, remember?
But nothing's been proved yet. You could try to get an injunction.
Oh, thanks.
Where are you going?
Well, I can't stay here. Should have kept my big mouth shut, shouldn't I?